Good afternoon, everybody. It's Lazy Eye Beauty, and I'm coming to you with another video. This video is going to be about five types of people that you should avoid having in your circle. So this list is going to sound a little bit mean, but it's not mean at all. It's just common sense. And if you want to be able to keep your sanity and have a good space and avoid as much negativity as possible, you definitely want to avoid having these people in your circle of friends. And if you do, you want to keep your interactions with them to a minimum. So I'm going to start with number one, the person that is always broke. I'm not talking about somebody that fell on a hard time. Maybe they lost their job, or maybe they're just having some financial hardships at a certain period of time, because we all go through that. It happens to the best of us. But I'm talking about the person, this person has a job, or maybe they don't have a job, but the point is that they are always broke and asking you for money. It's not the fact that they're broke, it's the fact that they're always broke and asking you for money. They always come to you with their hand out. And this is the thing with this particular person, if you ask, if they ask you for money and you say yes, they're going to come back again and ask you again because you said yes, and they are going to exhaust their resources as many times as they possibly can because they're looking at you as a means or a source of income. They're actually counting the money that you regularly give them in their budget. I'm telling you, because they have gotten so accustomed to asking you for money. And if you keep this person in your circle, what's gonna happen is they're eventually gonna get back up on their feet, and then you're not gonna see them again anyways, or you're gonna get so pissed off, you're gonna wind up snapping on them, and then you're gonna have a part of your character coming out that you didn't mean to come out. So just avoid that tragedy from taking place from the very beginning, and don't have somebody in your circle that's constantly asking you for money, because you make enough money for you and your family to survive, and maybe you do make enough money to give, but that's money that you could be saving, and that's your hard-earned money. You shouldn't have somebody constantly asking you for money, and y'all are friends. They're not your family. They're not your child. They're just a friend. You know what I'm saying? Number two, the depressed person, the person who's just habitually depressed. They're always on Facebook talking about how nobody likes them, nobody loves them. They're always complaining to you about how they hate life and how they want to kill themselves all the time, and how they just don't have anything to hope for. And they're always blaming things on that condition. This is the reason why you don't want to have this person in your circle. Number one, you're going to start to feel emotionally drained because this person's going to be so upset and unhappy all the time, and it's going to start to rub off on you. So you're going to notice that you're going to start having some of their negative thoughts yourself, and that's just not something that you want to happen, especially in a time like this where we have to stay motivated and encouraged to be able to achieve the things that we want to achieve. So you definitely don't want to have somebody that's always talking about how depressed they are in your circle. And this is another reason why you don't want to have somebody that's always depressed in your circle. They don't ever want to take accountability for the things that they do. They always want to blame it on that condition, saying, well, my depression just makes me act this way. This is the thing. The best thing that you can do for somebody who is depressed is, put them in the direction of something or someone that can actually help them, that is licensed to help them. But you can't come in and try to sweep the day and rescue them, because I know that's what we try to do. I've tried to do it before too. You think, well, maybe if I can just show you that there's more to life than what you know, you'll be excited about life and you'll want to live. No, because a person is going to be depressed for as long as they decide they want to be depressed. And for those who say, what would you know about it? I know, because I was depressed for years. And basically, only thing I did was complain about my feelings and how I was and what I was going through to people. And I would vent to whoever was willing to listen, but it never got any better. It never got any better. The only time that I actually was free from depression finally and haven't been depressed for years was when I was actually in my time by myself, when I was having no choice but to seek God and having no choice but to deal with my feelings alone, away from people. So, you know, that's why I can say I know that as many times as, even though you may feel like you want to talk to them and have them around you all the time, the best thing that you can do is just put them in the place of somebody that can actually help them, that's licensed to do so. Because you can only do so much. It's not like you're a doctor. And if you want to take that job on for yourself, you can. But eventually you're going to feel drained and you just don't want to do that continuously. And what's going to happen is you're going to wind up snapping on that person anyway, no matter how good of a person you are, because you're going to be tired that they're always wanting so much from you and you're always giving so much and never getting anything in return of that relationship. Basically meaning you're giving them encouragement, but they're not even capable of returning the favor and giving you encouragement back. Only thing they're doing is coming to you with more problems. And on the day that you actually might need somebody to uplift you, if you're talking to them, they might bring you further down the hill. So just don't have somebody like that in your circle. You can help people like that from time to time, but you don't want those people in your day-to-day circle. You know, kind of want to keep them at bay. Number three, the person who is always angry. Angry people. People who are mad at the world. They get mad at the lady at the grocery store. They get mad at the waitress at the restaurant. They get mad at all the customers at their job. They hate their coworkers. Their family members are evil. They always want to fight and always, you know, start something. Avoid this person, because a person that's angry, they can't show love to you. They can't be anything but angry towards you. The second that you say something that offends them or that is contrary to their beliefs, they're going to want to fight you. And then you're going to wind up having physical altercations and y'all going to be in jail. You know what I'm saying? I don't know about you, but I ain't trying to get locked up and ruin my record over something stupid. It's never that serious. Just get over it. You don't have to get mad at everybody, you know? But somebody that's always, always getting angry, that can't control their temper, stay away from them, because they're going to want to fight you all the time. Number five. Number four. You want to avoid people with absolutely nothing to lose. They don't have a house. They don't have a car. They don't even have their own place. They don't work. They don't have any children. They're not married. They don't have anything to lose. You know what I'm saying? You just want to avoid this person, because a person with nothing to lose doesn't understand the value of things. They don't work hard for what they have. So they're not going to respect any of your things either. So let's say that you're picking them up and they're riding in your car. You really think that they're going to care about the fact that it's probably not the best thing to do to smoke in there? No, they're gonna whip it on out, you know? Or they might try to open up their drink in your car. Or when they come over, they're always gonna wanna throw parties at your place, and they're not gonna clean up anything, and they'll break stuff, and they can't replace it because they don't have any money to replace it. And they're gonna disrespect you and your own house. It's like that person that asks for a ride, and they get in your car and they want to tell you what temperature to put your air on, and they want to tell you what music you should be playing. 9 times out of 10, those people don't even have vehicles. That's why they don't respect yours. Because if they had a vehicle, they would know that you don't do that. It's not proper etiquette. You just sit back and enjoy the ride and be appreciative that you're not walking. That's what you do when you get in someone else's car. And when you go to someone else's house, you wait until they offer you things. And when someone comes over to your house, you're supposed to offer them, oh, would you like a glass of water? Would you like something to drink? And you would feed them normal people stuff. But these people don't know how to do those things because they have nothing to lose. And another thing, when they have nothing to lose, they'll post all sorts of stuff on social media about you and them and the things that you're doing. So let's say y'all went out to the bar and got a little tipsy. They'll post that stuff on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook, because they think it's funny. Not realizing that if your job sees it, you may not have a job either. So just make sure that you don't have people like that in your circle, because they are dangerous, okay? They are dangerous to people who have something to lose. And then number five is the user. This is, I saved this one for the last because it's very important. a user will take you for everything that you own. And when they're done, they'll be gone. Case in point. And that's why you don't need to have them in your circle. So if you have money, they're going to want that. If you have a car, they're going to want you to drive them around all the time. If you have a place to stay, they're going to want to be sleeping on your couch. If you have food, they're going to come over to your crib and eat it all up. And they're never going to return the favor and do anything for you. When you ask, they can't, because they don't have anything. And sometimes people who are users, they make good money, but they're just always going to try to seek the opportunity to find a way to get something out of somebody else, because they get a kick out of using people. That's not something that changes just because you go and you get money. So make sure that you don't have someone that's a user in your life, because they're never going to care about what it is that you need. It's going to be about them 100% of the time. And you cannot make this person see any type of reason, because they're just going to feel like, hey, I have the right to use whoever I want. And if you won't let me use you, then I'll find somebody else to use. So there you go. You have it. Those are 5 people that you need to avoid having in your circle, if you want to remain sane anyways. So I hope that you all have a wonderful Sunday, and that if you like this video, please comment, like, and subscribe. And I hope you have a beautiful day.